Hi, in this video, we will dockerize a Python application. This is an application made by Patrick, as known as the Python engineer. You can check his YouTube channel and the first part of the video in the link below. If you like this kind of collaborations, please like the video, subscribe with notifications on. Thank you so much. So let's get started.
Let's start with the demo. And first of all, let's clone the Git repository. Click the copy button, go on terminal, and type git clone paste. This should take a while. Now let's step into the ml-deployment directory, then Docker Flask, and let's open this with our favorite IDE, for example, Visual Studio Code. We can type code space dot. Here, let's create a Docker file, capital D without extension. We need the Docker file to build the Docker image. We need a base image, for example, from Python 3.8. And then we can copy from source to destination the requirements.txt files, which has all the dependencies we need. So copy requirements.txt space dot, which means here in this folder in the image file system. Now we can run the pip install -r requirements.txt command. We can do this because we're using the Python image. And now something very specific for this project, we need a specific command. So run python -c in quotes import NLTK, which stands for Natural Language Toolkit. We also need NLTK.downloadOMW/1.4. We are simulating some requirements that we need in order to run this container, and nltk.download wordnet. And we are done for the specific requirements for this project. Now we can copy dot dot, which means everything inside the Docker image file system. We can inform that we will use the port 5000, expose 5000, and now a command which is the same that we ran in the previous video without using Docker. So cmd flask run --host equal 0.0.0.0--port equal 5000, and the Docker file is done. Now, to make our life easier, we can create a docker-compose.yml file. We don't really need that because usually the Docker Compose is used for multiple services. We will have just one, but let's do it. Let's define a version, 3.7, and the services. We'll have just one service here. Let's name it MLApp, which stands for Machine Learning App. As a container name, MLApp. This is the default container name when we will run the container based on the image. As image, MLApp, or even better, FrancescoX6/MLApp. You can replace FrancescoX6 with your Docker Hub account name, and ports 5000. Don't need any volumes, but we need the build value with context dot. It means in this folder, and as Docker file with capital D. We don't really need this last line, but in case we want to name our Docker file capital D with a different name, the name of this value should also change. Okay, now with the same command, we can build the image and run the container. But first of all, let's step into the right directory. And now docker compose app --build. This means build the image and then run the container based on that image. It's done already. Nice. And now we have to test it. And we will use Postman this time as endpoint. http://localhost:5000/predict. Let's add the header content type application/json. We need to change the HTTP verb to post. And as a body, we'll provide a text as key. And as a value, for example, may the force be with you. I hope you'll get a reference. Let's test it. Okay, this is positive. Nice. It works, but we are using Docker to run this service. Now let's try I hate you. This should not disappoint us. Yes, it's negative. Okay, so we have tested our application. It works. You can also see the logs here in the application logs of the Docker Compose. Now let's do something else. Let's store this image on Docker Hub. To do this, it's very, very simple. You can just type docker compose push. Since we have defined as an image our Docker Hub account, it will automatically create a Docker Hub repository and it will also push the image. Everything in just one command. Now, this will take a while, so let's skip this part. There we go. Here is the image that we just created. Now, let's clear the images and containers on our machine. Docker images, let's remove them. Docker RMI-F85, the name of the image. Docker PS-A. Let's remove the containers. So now our computer is clean. Now, let's type docker run -p 5000:5000 and francescoxx/mlapp for me, but you can replace francescoxx with your Docker Hub account. By the way, if you run this exact command, it will work because I pushed that image on my Docker Hub repository, which is public. Since we don't have this image on our machine, it will download the image on our machine first. To be precise, it will pull the image and then it will run the container. It seems that it worked. Let's do another test. http://localhost:5000/predict. Let's change the header again, content type application/json. As a body text column, for example, I love Docker and Python. This has to be a post request. Send it. And it works. But in this case, we are using an existing image. We are not building this image on our machine. And it still works.
So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and thank you, Patrick, for creating this amazing Python application. If you like this kind of collaborations, just subscribe. Let me know in the comments what you like and what would you like me to dockerize. And see you on the next video. Bye.